In this video, I'm going to share with you the best practices and techniques to create a perfect ball bounce in After Effects. So without wasting any time, let's jump in. Hello everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is my first tutorial video, so please like this video, subscribe to my channel and hit that bell icon to stay updated with the upcoming videos. So this is our scene setup. If you are new to After Effects, you'll have to create a new composition. As I already have created one, here are my settings. I have selected focal resolution and 30 frames per second, but you can choose your desired settings from these presets or manually add the values here. For most of you guys, 1920 by 1080 resolution would be suitable. First, I'm gonna create a ball. To do that, you can use the ellipse tool to create a simple circle and animate that. But I'm gonna create a sphere using a ball texture, which will give us more realistic rotations. I'm gonna go to the Google and search for tennis ball texture. Go to the images. And this is the texture that I'm gonna use. Download it. Drag and drop it into the timeline. Then go to the Effects and Presets panel and search for CC Sphere. Drag and drop it on the layer and it will convert our texture into a sphere. Let's adjust a few settings in the Effects Control panel. Set the light height to 70, light direction to minus 45, ambient to 20. And you can play with these settings to change the lighting and shading of the ball. Select the anchor point tool and drag the anchor point to the bottom of the ball. This will be helpful as we'll be adding some stretch and squash to the ball later in the video. Scale the ball down to 50%. Press Ctrl R to show guides. Add one guide here which will be the peak point of the first bounce and add another guide at the bottom to represent the ground for the ball. Press P for position and here's the tip. Before I start any keyframes, I'm gonna separate the position dimensions. Now I can add keyframes to X position and Y position separately, which will give us more control over the animation. I will animate the bounces on the Y axis and then move the ball on the X axis from left to right or right to left. Go to frame 1 and move the ball up to meet the top guide. Add a keyframe. Move over 10 frames and bring the ball down to the bottom guide. Add another keyframe. In a good ball bounce animation, the ball will move slowly at its peak and reach its highest speed just before hitting the ground. So to achieve that kind of motion, select keyframes, press F9 to easy ease, go to graph editor. Make sure you are seeing the value graph. And pull the handles to create a curve like this. Now, you need to remember a few things in order to read the value graph. The frames on which the curve looks horizontal or more flat, the ball will have a slow speed at that point. And the frames on which the curve is more steep or vertical, it will have a fast speed. To ensure that the ball spends more time at its peak moving slowly and less time as it approaches the ground moving faster. During the top to bottom motion, the ball should cover 25% of the distance in 50% of the time, and the rest of 75% of the distance in the remaining 50% of the time. Tweak these handles a little bit to make sure of that. Alright, let's see the preview. Let's animate the second bounce. The duration of the first bounce is 20 frames. These are 10 frames, but if you notice, this is half the bounce. If we complete this bounce over to the other side, it will be a full bounce of 20 frames. So if the first bounce is 20 frames, I'm gonna make the second bounce to be 14 or maybe 12 frames. Go ahead 12 frames and add another keyframe. And pull the handles to create a curve like this. While doing this, make sure that the angle of this handle and this handle is the same. The length of the handle shouldn't necessarily be the same, but the angle should be the same. and every new bounce should be smaller than the previous bounce. Let's animate the third bounce. Go 8 frames ahead, add a keyframe. Same rules, pull the handles to create a curve like this. The angle of the handle should be the same, and every new bounce should be smaller than the previous bounce. The fourth bounce would be 5 frames. I'm gonna fast forward the video as the rules are same for all the bounces. The fifth bounce would be 3 frames. The next bounce will be 2 frames, then I'm gonna add another 3 bounces of 1 frame each. Alright, let's preview it. Now, I'm gonna animate it on the x-axis so that it makes more sense. Go to first frame, move the ball to the left until you can't see the ball. Add a keyframe. Now go to frame 60, move the ball to the right and add the second keyframe. Let's see how it looks. Alright, we need to slow down the ball at the end and add some rotation to it. Now to slow down the ball at the end on the x-axis, pull this handle to the left. Remember, the frames on which the curve is more flat or horizontal, the ball will move slow at that point. That's it. Now to add the rotation, go to frame 1. Let me change the Z rotation to 65. Then on the Y rotation property, add a keyframe. Go to frame 65 and add the second keyframe. Rotate the ball by 3 cycles. Then go to frame 70 and rotate the ball a little backward to give it a more subtle effect. Press F9 to easy ease and pull this handle to the left to slow down the rotation at the end. Tweak this handle just a little bit. Alright, let's preview it to see what we've done so far. And we are doing great. By the way, if you notice, our value graph also looks like a ball bounce path, but just upside down. Sometimes you'll need to bend the rules and tweak the animation a little bit to make it look like as you want. And that's totally fine. To enhance the animation further, I'm gonna add some stretch and squash to the ball. So when the ball is at its top speed and when it hits the ground, there will be some deformation in the shape of the ball. Press S for scale, unlock the properties, go to frame 1, add a keyframe. Go to frame 8 and change the scale to 45 and 55. Go to frame 10 and change the scale to 55 and 45. So that when the deformation is happening, the volume of the ball remains the same. On frame 12, change the scale to 45 and 55. On frame 16, when the ball is at its peak, change the scale back to 50%. on frame 21, change the scale to 45 and 55. Again, when the ball is hitting the ground, switch the scale properties. When the ball is again at the peak on the third bounce, change the scale back to 50% and that's it. You can add this stretch and squash to the remaining bounces if you want, but I'm just gonna skip it. Select all the keyframes, press F9 to easy ease, and let's take a look. And see, it's looking pretty good. Now I'm gonna add the shadow to the ball, then tweak its blurriness and opacity. This is kind of a secondary thing to do, but it will make the animation much more appealing. To add the shadow, duplicate this layer and create a pre-composition. I'm gonna call it shadow. Go to effects and presets panel and search for fill. Drag and drop it and change its color. Make it a 3D layer. I'll nick the scale properties and scale it down to 30%. Change the X rotation to 180 degrees. After that, align it with the ball. To add the blurriness, head for Gaussian blur. Drag and drop it on the pre-composition. I want the shadow to be more blurry when the ball is at the peak and make it more visible when it hits the ground. When the ball hits the ground, change the blurriness to 70. And when the ball is in the air, make the blurriness to 130. Select and easy ease all the keyframes. I'm gonna do the same thing with the opacity. I want the shadow to have less opacity when it's in the air and make it more prominent when it's hitting the ground. When the ball hits the ground, change the opacity to 90%. When the ball is in the air, make the opacity to 50%. Select and ease all the keyframes. Alright, let's see the preview. I'm gonna turn on the motion blur and see the preview for the last time. Then I'm gonna render it via Adobe Media Encoder. So that's it for today guys, I hope you have enjoyed the video. Please like and subscribe to my channel, I'd really appreciate that. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comment section. Stick around and I'll see you in the next video. Have a great day.